Now, if you've been following us on our Hindi channel, you know that we recently got the Dyson V11 Absolute Pro in for a review. And Ashish was using it for a very long time. Though, I mean, with all tech users, I mean, obviously I would want to get my hands on that as well. So I've been using the Dyson V11 Pro personally for the last 1 month or so. And this is a long-term review of it. See, if you want to just get a normal review on whether you should buy it or not, yeah, the Hindi channel has that covered. But right now, I want to talk about how the Dyson product has actually lasted in multiple homes. My home, my editor's house, and then obviously Ashish's house. And then in the midst of it all, Ashish also took the Dyson Dust Challenge, which, well, definitely had some interesting revelations. I mean, we all think that, yeah, our house is getting cleaned every day. So apart from some dirt in some very tough to reach corners, everything else should be clean, right? So yeah, in this video, we'll be talking about whether the Dyson V11 Absolute Pro is, well, an absolute pro or not, whether it's still worth the money or not, and what all things you might not be aware of in respect to where all the dust might be in your houses. Let's get started. Okay, so first up, I just want to talk about the design for a bit. See, okay, if you're looking at the B-rolls of the product right now, you might be able to spot a little bit of scratches here and there. I mean, that's the way a product will be after so much months of heavy usage. But it's not like it's going to break or anything. I mean, the Dyson V11 Absolute Pro looks like it's something that will last a very long time. It's built to last. And one thing that I'll give the company credit for is the fact that the attachments, which we talked about in our full review, was so easy to attach on, are still as good as day one. I mean, usually what happens is that when you have all these clipping attachments, they usually tend to get loose over a period of time. That's not been the case with the Dyson V11 Absolute Pro. But yeah, basically what I'm trying to say is that despite being used for a very long time, I mean, it's used every day, the attachments haven't gotten loose, the device still performs to its maximum potential, and the best part is that cleaning it has been so effortless. See, with other cleaners, I think this is one thing that Ashish also pointed out, and this is one thing that really appeals to me as well. With all the other vacuum cleaners out there, cleaning is always a big hassle. In the sense that, okay, you can clean the house and everything, but then when it comes to cleaning the vacuum cleaner itself, you have to dispose of the box or the bag, and then you have to take apart a lot of items and then finally clean it. Well, it's a big task. With the Dyson V11, all you have to do is just open it up and, well, throw it in the trash. That's it. As simple as that. The Dyson V11 makes everything so seamless, so neat. But yeah, basically what I'm trying to say is that the Dyson V11 makes things very convenient and very easy. So yeah, the design not only is very user-friendly and intuitive, but is also meant to last for a very long time, which brings us to the long-term part of it. See, I've been using it for a very long time and I haven't really faced any issues whatsoever. Usually you can tend to like feel, okay, yeah, this product is going to break down or something like that. Not the case here. I mean, obviously you would not expect that from a product that's priced this high, but yeah, that is another, well, satisfactory thing to have. Now, another thing that the Dyson V11 excels at is the battery life. So usually all electronic devices have a deterioration in their battery life. And I won't say that the Dyson V11 hasn't had any sort of battery deterioration, but I will say that it's negligible to the point where you can't even notice that. Maybe a 1 or 1.5 minutes here and there on the medium mode, but that's it. Nothing extraordinary for me to say or complain about, ki, oh my God, the battery has reduced and something like that. The battery still lasts very long on the medium mode. If you switch to the economy mode, you can use it for hours and hours and hours. And if you're using it to clean some very tight to get corners and everything, the turbo mode works there and it still works for 10 full minutes. So yeah, that's great. Also, one thing that Ashish highlighted in his full review of the Dyson V11 was that, well, he felt that there could have been some replaceable or rechargeable batteries that, you know, could have made things easier. Well, with the new model, you get that and you get a total of 120 minutes of charge, which is something really, really nice. Okay, now let's talk about the dust challenge that happened with Ashish's place. So what happened was Ashish was out of town for a week and then he came back and Dyson approached him like, okay, yeah, let's just do a dust challenge. And I just joined in to see for the fun of it. I was like, I just wanted to see how it actually happens and everything, because Ashish really, really prides himself on the overall cleanliness. At least that is what I used to think, till the point that Dyson actually came up to his house and started, you know, taking things apart and showing what all portions you can find dust in. You see, household dust is much more complex than the various sized particles used by your standard vacuum cleaner tests. It is just a mixture of components including dust mites, dust mite feces, bacteria, mold, small insects and particles. Now, their droppings and dead bodies are what makes those allergens that everyone really hates. Now, while they're hidden to the naked eye, they are widely spread on various surfaces on our houses where we eat, sit, play, sleep, such as floors, mattresses, sofas, beds, carpets, and practically even the floor. Now, this is one thing that you might not be aware of, but dust actually contains a high percentage of your human skin cells as well. So a lot of dirt around your house is basically your own skin that just dropped off. And then there are the dust mites that thrive in dark and warm conditions like mattresses, which really, really cannot be cleaned by regular techniques. In fact, beds can contain over 1 million dust mites, and that is a very, very big number. And obviously that really opens one's eyes to see, understand, okay, I am actually living on all of this dust. Because the thing is, when you're looking at everything with the naked eye, you really can't see that. But once you start using a microscope, start actually looking at it, and you're like, okay, this thing is really dirty, like genuinely dirty. So the way that the Dyson V11 works is that it actually has a much better filter as opposed to other vacuum cleaners, so that it cleans mites up to 0.3 microns, which is a very, very finite and a very small, minute number, which means that effectively it's cleaning up to 99.97%. I mean, that's what the company claims. And to be honest, I am not surprised by that. Not only are Dyson's products something that I personally prefer a lot and they are good, but after this study, they have the actual facts to back up their products. I mean, literally everything that they showcased during that so-called dust challenge was literally an eye-opener, to the point where I was like, I mean, if Ashish's house is something that I used to consider so neat and clean, and then there are so many dust over there, so I'm like, what about my house? I mean, yeah, things could be very dirty over there. And worse still, this studio where we're recording. Okay, now I'm starting to get a little claustrophobic. I think I need to get a Dyson cleaner here to clean the studio as well. But yeah, so that is what happens, is that as a consumer, you probably won't be aware of the kind of dust and the kind of environment that you're living in. Having a vacuum cleaner like the Dyson, which has a very, very finite and a very good filter, helps you in cleaning everything. Obviously, you still have to manually clean everything, and that is one thing that Ashish also pointed, and I also feel that when you compare it with all those robot cleaners, the one biggest advantage over there is that it's made for lazy bums like me who do not want to get up and clean their stuff, hence living in a dirty home. I mean, for me, I would much rather prefer a robot cleaner on a normal basis who would just clean everything. That said, now that I've seen all that dust challenge, I know that a robot cleaner will never be able to get into those nooks and corners and clean everything. Heck, my keyboard was so dirty, and when Dyson cleaned it up, I was like, dude, how was I even typing on this thing? Like, for me, cleaning my keyboard was basically just using my sanitizer to just, well, spray on it, and yeah, it's done. Until Dyson showed me the light and showed me how neat and clean things could actually be. So yeah, big props and big thanks to Dyson for having that dust challenge and actually enlightening us. And if you guys would like to read more about this, we'll leave a link down there in the description box so you guys can also understand what all dust particles you guys might be living in your houses, in your offices and everywhere, even in your car. Okay, trust me, your car can be super dirty. So yeah, make sure to check out that link in the description box below. And as for the Dyson V11 Pro, absolute pro, well, it is an absolute pro. Throughout this process of using the Dyson cleaner extensively for cleaning our cars and houses, our rooms, everything, I can say that the product is not only meant to last for a very long time, but the best part is that throughout this time period, its performance hasn't deteriorated even by 1%. So, I mean, I'm not going to say it's even negligible. even not like the performance hasn't deteriorated by even a percent, and that is a very, very big thing to say. So yeah, I understand a lot of consumers out there might look at Dyson's products and be like, yeah man, that's way too overpriced. And trust me, I am one of those guys who was like, dude, I know it's going to be a great product, but it's like way too overpriced. It's way too overpriced. And that's what I'm trying to make you guys understand. It's not overpriced. It's very, very well priced for the kind of features that it offers. Do not compare the V11 Absolute Pro to your normal vacuum cleaner. It's like, it's not even in the same league. The V11 Absolute Pro is miles, miles ahead of the kind of performance and the kind of cleaning that it can offer. And trust me, once you start investing in that and you start cleaning with it, you will start to realize that, okay, this is money well spent. So yeah, that was my long-term review of the Dyson V11 Absolute Pro. There will be a link down there in the description box if you guys want to buy it. And trust me, from one friend to another friend, go and buy it. And this video hasn't been sponsored in any way whatsoever. Like seriously, we do not do sponsored videos whatsoever. And this video is just me talking to you straight out of the heart. That dust challenge was something that Dyson just wanted to conduct, but I really wanted to make a long-term review on it to highlight that, yeah, a lot of us take things for granted when they shouldn't be. And cleanliness is one of those things that you should not take for granted. Till then, this is Varun from Guiding Tech, and I'll see you in the next one.